There were a few dragon spawns in this area.
Did you say something?
I wanted to make sure this one didn't come with the giant.
Something's happening.
Normally, if a giant and a dragon are spawned together to do a fight scene, you're not supposed to interfere. It's just there for you to watch.
And yes?
If you interfere with the fight scene, the dragon or the giant might glitch out later on.
Of course.
Makes for bad YouTubing. Whoop.
So, where are we going now?
That didn't happen. Well, as usual, I think I've reached level 50 with my character. Everyone knows what happens when you reach level 50.
Everyone.
Means you pretty much won the game. Over and over. You start running out of things to do. Let's face it.
You did it again. And I thought killing dragons was difficult.
If you're a role player, if you're a true role player, you will not do everything with your character.
If you look around here, you will often find butterflies.
I mean, I promise you, you will not do everything with the same character. You just won't. You know, be the vampire, be the werewolf. What's the other thing? You know, do the Dark Brotherhood thing. Be in the Thieves Guild. Be a blade. I mean, come on, really? You are not going to do all that with one character, unless you're, you know, trying to win the
yes.
game. You know, there are players out there that just want to win the game. They're not role playing at all. They're just, what else can I do? I want to do that. I want to be this. I want to have everything. I want all of it. They even have mods so that you can have all of it. Like, I want to be a blade and I want to be a Greybeard. You know, that kind of thing.
Stormblade, it's an honor.
Don't try blocking if you have two weapons. You will only get confused. Much better to hit twice anyway. All right, then.
A word from the wise. Someone posted in one of my videos, hey, they didn't say, hey, Driscoll, but they said something, I forget what they called me, but anyway, they said, why don't you make more of those videos where you're just sitting in front of the camera talking about whatever. You know, I go on their channel and they have zero videos. They have no thing. So when someone posts a comment like that, and they have zero videos on their channel, I'm thinking, oh, okay, this person just wants me to entertain them. You know, that's all they're looking for. Let's go on Driscoll's channel and see what he's saying. See what he's saying about us. You know, that kind of thing. Oh great, now I've got this on both video screens. Why? I hit a button on my mouse and now I've got duplicate displays. Okay, now I've got the HAL 9000 display on both videos. Okay, now I'm back to normal. I hate when my screensaver just kicks in. What's going on? What did I miss? I mean, I might do another video where I just sit in front of
You
my
know,
camera.
sometimes it really irritates me that you are always deciding where we are going. I think it's my turn to lead the way for a change.
I just knew you were going to
Oh
say that.
well, I obviously cannot force you.
Okay, I pick something different.
Anytime.
But yeah, I could sit in front of the camera and yap for 20 minutes about something. The deal is, I've already done that. I've said all I can say about it, I suppose.
I must speak to Delphine at once. There's no time to lose.
So maybe, you know, if someone has a subject they want me to
Goodbye.
Talk about, and it's something I haven't talked about before, then sure, I might do a video like that. Every time I ask for ideas, I don't get none. Is that like a... That's a double negative. I don't get none.
I take the highway, and you take the low way.
This is fun.
So we were escorting Esbern to Riverwood. It took a while because I want to see how well he fights.
Take a look.
In all the places we were going to.
All right then.
Let me show you. I know I had it here somewhere.
Esbern, what?
Give me just a moment. Here it is. Come, let me show. You see, right here.
How are you today? Yeah, take care of yourself. Hello, Fred. I'd better get going.
Oh, he's one of the guys that you... I think you turned him into a vampire. I rarely walk into that guy. What's he doing out here? Maybe he goes out for strolls or something.
Good to see you, my friend.
I look forward to our next meeting.
Or he's waiting for somebody to kill me. Someone out here is getting ready to backstab me, I betcha.
Need a ride?
Well, we're not going to stay here for
Where
long.
Where do you want
either.
To go?
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
You ever met one of them cats? Khajiit.
So I've been downloading all kinds of mods, trying them out, updating mods that I currently have that have been updated in the last few months. And thinking about what my
yes?
next what my
so,
next character is gonna
going
be.
Hmm? All right then.
We got Braith with us? Oh, level 1. Oh, yeah, that's right. I wanted to see how well she fights at level 1. And she fights very badly at level 1. So you have to give her extremely good weapons to make up for her low levelness. You know, give her, like, a weapon that does 100 damage kind of thing.
From what I hear, you're the one gave the Thalmor a black eye. Sure know how to pick your enemies, don't you? All right, then.
I don't abide fancy clothes, but you look like you might. I hear Radiant Raiments has a large selection.
Yeah? Take a look.
Oh, what's wrong? What's going on with his eyeballs? What is that all about?
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen that before. The inside out or something? Oh, I'm gonna click on you, mister, until your eyeballs are... Okay, that's better.
Take a look.
So I've been trying different camera mods where you can have the camera over your left shoulder, your right shoulder, directly above your head, at your kneecaps, whatever. Trying different mod, what do they call it? Follower mods, companion mods. Because I want to play a female in the next game. But there are no potions, decent
head over
dudes.
To Angeline's Aromatics. All right.
I looked and I looked, and there's not one decent male dude that you can download if you're playing a female character. You know, a character that you could have a love-hate relationship with. There's none of that. But on the guy side, if you're playing a guy character, there's a whole slew of female NPCs you can download that your character can banter with or get married to and have drama in that style. But, man, that must suck to be a girl and you're playing a girl character and there's no guys in Skyrim, you know. Or, of course, I could be biased. Being a dude, maybe I don't see...
Welcome to the Bard's College. It's such a pleasure to see you again.
Like at work, right?
I see that you have found the first Book of Chants. Congrats. You have done a good job.
Oh, let this guy finish what he's rattling on about.
The college has decided to reward you for each book you find. I hope you will find this sum sufficient for now. There's more to come. I take it you will continue to help Vilya finding the other books? Good. I knew you wouldn't let Vilya down. I'll mark the location of the book on your map. Good luck.
So this time I didn't force feed him into solitude. Because I used to do that. He would just stay at Dawnstar forever. And so I would move him into the Bard's College and then he would act like a bard. But I found out, if you just wait like a few weeks, he'll send you a letter saying that he's decided to stay at the Bard's College, and he moves there on his own. Anyway, so what I was saying is, at work, women will tell me that they saw this amazing-looking dude. And I'm like, okay, where's this amazing looking dude? They point him out to me, and I'm like,
this will be fun.
Whatever. Because I'm a dude, so I can't tell if another dude is hot or not. I don't have that power.
Hello, friend.
So I'm probably like that with Skyrim, you know. Being a dude in the game, I probably can't tell what other dudes in the game are hot.
Good to see you.
That a female character would even be remotely interested in making a companion with.
Good to see you.
That could just be me. Maybe some guys know it. Other dudes. What is it I'm trying to say? Maybe other guys can look at other guys and say, oh, that guy's hot or not. You know, that kind of thing.
Sorry, I was lost in thought. I'm planning my wedding, you see. So many details to work out.
But it just seems like most of the guys in Skyrim are just knuckle draggers. You know, they're just one notch above Neanderthals. Or the dudes tend to be you know, Justin Bieber type characters. You know, boy band stuff. Or emo characters. Or what's the other one? You know, Marilyn Manson. Some women think Marilyn Manson is hot stuff, I suppose. I'd be curious to know if Marilyn Manson is hot or not. Now maybe women players hate Vilya and Sophie and Arissa and But I know they almost all, I hate to say this, but almost all female players, I'm speaking in general, of course, all female players go for that Khajiit character. I already forgot his name. Which I cannot stand. But he works with Vilya.
I've been looking for you.
Oh, who died?
Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. A letter. Not sure who from. He wouldn't say, just that he was a friend of yours. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Okay, maybe another word wall. Someone was impressed by my shouting. Oh, what's that stupid cat's name? The purple one? Talks out of character all the time. Constantly breaking the fourth wall kind of thing. Okay, I went on Reddit to see what the top Skyrim custom voice followers are. So Inigo is the name I was trying to remember. That's the number one. Number two is that Arlen Dawnstone. I think she talks too much. Number three is Vilya. Yeah, number three, that makes sense. Number four is Anna's NPCs. And spoiler alert, they're all the same NPC. They're all the same character. They all want to be bards. They all want to be singers. Something to do, maybe the creator of Anna's NPCs wishes that, you know, she was a singer. So she tries to force players to hear her songs and her mods.
So, where are we going now?
How do you pronounce this next one? Vicania? From Baldur's Gate?
Kirava offered me to stay for free if I helped out with the cleaning of the B&B Bob. Of course I accepted.
Okay, there's Dr. Benjamin Dune. He's a goofball. Then there's Sophia, another goofball. Recorder is a goofball.
If it hadn't been for that arrogant bastard Mercurio.
Mirai? I don't remember her.
He was bragging about his magic skills all
Arisa,
the time.
Arisa? She's okay.
Show me how to cast a fireball. She simply refused.
Hoth.
He said that countryside
not the greatest, but notice how
fit for any spell casting.
Number 13 is the first dude on the list of best voiced followers.
Found instructions on how to cast a fireball.
After that you got Rigmore, and then you have interesting NPCs, and then the rest are just
next morning,
garbage.
I decided to surprise him.
You know, Roderick,
I cast
garbage.
A fireball. And it worked.
Minerva,
well,
meh.
Maybe a little too well.
Hell, I used Hell once.
And ended up under Kirava's
wasted time. Yeah, so there's only like two guys on this list.
Kirava was screaming, and Talon Jay.
The rest are all chicks.
Water all over her to put out the fire. Kirava fell into Talon Jay's arms, crying of gratitude. You know what? I think that from this moment on, she was in love with him too. If I'm right about this. I actually was doing them a favor with that fireball. Don't you think so too? However, Kirava wasn't at all happy with me. She threatened to charge me for damaging her inn, and said it was too risky to have me in the house. At that point, I felt it was time for me to leave. So I took off for Whiterun. But I'll tell you more about this some other time. Right now we have other things to do. Don't you think so too?
So in my next playthrough, I don't think I'll have Vilya in the game, but I don't think I'll use Vilya.
And today's coming. There was a great battle here in Whiterun. It was quite thrilling. I must compose a song about it someday.
Is she's more of a guy's chick than a chick's chick, if that makes
sense.
Some
parting advice? Women love...
At least in my configuration. So I'm going to have to change a whole lot of my Skyrim if I'm going to play a female character.
Yes? Of course.
Because I have a lot of scripted stuff in my game where it assumes you're a dude.
Have you read any good books lately?
So I'll have to yank all those out.
I don't think so.
I'm finally getting
put in mods that assume that you're a female character.
I just wish I had more time to read it.
Because it just...
How can I argue with that?
It breaks the game so much when... NPCs are talking to you.
There are so many books I
like you're a female and you're not female. Like they're wolf whistling you and stuff. It's like,
nowadays,
what's going on here?
I don't have time to read my own diary.
Not my problem.
You know, some women like to be wolf whistled, some don't. Well, I'm old school. I come from an age where women liked it when they got wolf whistled. But in reality, I think if a woman's attractive, she's going to get hit on every day by every single guy that comes near her. So by the time she's 25, by the time she's 30, she's probably seen maybe thousands and thousands of guys approach her. And of course, the women have to be on Prozac to cope with this stuff.
Until next time. Good afternoon.
Because usually whenever I see a hot chick, and yes, I'm going to say hot chick, by the time they're 40, they're just a hot mess. Because they've been used and abused by every dude there is out there. So some nice guy next door like me comes along and meets them, she's like,
do you hunt?
She is so sick of guys at that point in her life. It's like, really?
Nope. Sorry. Nothing.
You know, she's already a, what do they call it? Alcoholic, a drug user, heroin addict maybe. Slit her wrist a few times. All that before I get a chance to say something like what Tom Hanks would say in Big, you know, do you want to go somewhere and get like a milkshake or something? Or is that, maybe that was Napoleon Dynamite that talks like that. I thought we could go get a milkshake or something. This guy, he's been dead for quite a while in my solitude. He was killed by vampires, but his script jammed. So he's got this body that's never told to be cleaned by street sweepers at night. So the street sweepers just go around him. I think what I ended up doing was reanimated the dude, and then when he died, he turned into an ash pile, and then the ash pile went away after a while. So problem solved. So on my next playthrough, I was thinking of playing a female character that gets hit on all the time by the dudes, and maybe by some of the women. You and see how far I can go in that game before I go nuts. You're trying to do quests, and the guy companion that you bring
Welcome
along...
Welcome to the Bard's College. It's such a pleasure to see you again.
He's constantly asking
so you...
you
have found the third book as well?
For a quickie...
Excellent. Here's your reward. I'm happy to say that our evaluation of the chance is going well. But there's one more book we have to find. Or you and Willia, rather. You will help her find this last book too, won't you? Good. I'll mark the location of the last book on your map. I wouldn't want to go to that place myself, but you are, of course, an experienced adventurer.
So I'm letting Villia get all the chance. In Bardemville, they're called
Welcome
chance
back.
Instead of shouts.
It's always a pleasure to see you.
This will be fun. Shall we start searching for the book immediately?
How much do you?
Because I was getting tired of her asking me if I could train her to do fire, you know, cast fireballs or whatever. So I thought, you know, let's just get her to do the stuff.